So in this lecture we will understand the 120 degree mode of inverter. Okay? The last lecture is in the 180 degree mode of inverter. The circuit diagram of 3 phase inverter is as it is. Bridge type of inverter. So all of you again draw the circuit diagram of 3 phase inverter. This is your DC supply. Supply voltage is VS. Same name is given in the sequence in which it is coming. So this is 1, which number S1, S2, S3, S4, S5, S6. Here again for the simplicity, to understand the operation of 120 degree mode, here we take the 3 phase star connected balanced load condition. Now this is phase A, this is phase B, and this is phase C. And this is your inverter. You can see that it is open. All have impedance there. Say that the circuit diagram we have to for the 3 phase 180 degree mode. So, as you know, that the name 120 degree mode inverter means that each and every switch is converting for 120 degree mode. That's why it is called as a 120 degree mode of. So let's again draw the gate pulse for all 6 switches one by one, and then after we see the how to get the phase voltage VA0, VB0 and VC0 and then line voltage. So first we draw the waveform of gate pulse for all the 6 switches. So, you can see that in the first stage of phase A, the switch number S1 and S4 is connected in series. Yeah. So, as you know that both the switch must be turned on in complementary fashion. Otherwise, your source will be short circuited. Yeah. So, here S1 is obviously start from omega t is equal to 0. And end up here at 120. This is 60 degree, this is 120. But S4 is turned on at 180 degree. So it means between 120 to 180 degree mode of inverter, there is no thyristor connected from this leg. Leg number 1. So this is the 180 degree, 240 degree and 300 degree. As you know, each and every thyristor is converting for 120 degree duration. So here, between 120 to 180, no one thyristor will be converting from this region, as well as well. Each and every thyristor is converting for 120. So S1 is converting from 0 to 120 and then S4 is converting from 180 to 300. This is our 120. Then again from 300 to 360, no one will be conducting from this leg one S1 and S2, that is limit of between 300 to 360. Again from 360 degree, after that next cycle will start. So again your S1 will on for next 120 degree. Suppose I think there is a next cycle, so again this is 0 to 60 and this is 120 degree. This is the S1 conduction period. All of you understand this one? Conduction duration of S1 and S2. Is there a doubt when you are? Now next move for the gate pass for lane number 2, S3 and S6. S3 and so called IG3 for gate pass of S3 and IG6 gate pass of S6 region. Yeah. Now as you know that S1 and S3 must be turned on at an interval of 120 degrees space from each other, because we generate a 3-phase output at the 3-phase loop. So S3 must be turned on 120 degrees after S1. Same as I just in the 180 mode. Yeah, same way here, S5 must be turned on 120 degrees after turning on the S3. Okay. So turn on duration of S3 is what? From 120 to next 120 degrees up to 240. When you draw the any waveform or gate pass, always take the projection so that you can get the accurate waveform. Now next is S6. So here this is the 120, this is the 180, and this is the 240. So as you know that between the two thyristor conduction there is a 60 degree interval of gap. So here between 60 degree to this 120, neither S3 nor S6 will conduct. Clear? So here zero gate pulse for both the switches. But from 0 to 60 degree, your S6 will conduct. This is S3 conduction period and this is the S6 conduction period. Switch number 6, this way. Yeah. After 240 again, for next 60 degree, no one will conduct it. Neither S3 nor S6. So gate pulse is 0. But after 300 degree, your S6 will start for next 120 degree, between 300 to 60 degree. So now you can see that why initially between 0 to 60 degree you get the gate pulse? Because you can see that in the next cycle here, in the previous cycle 60 degree duration, your S6 will conduct it. So remaining 60 degree that will conduct in the next cycle. 300 to 360, that is duration of gate pass in this cycle. Then 360 to 60, it is means for the next cycle of 60 degree, your S6 will conduct. You can see here initially the 60 degree is conducting. It means that in the previous cycle for the 60 degree duration, this S6 will already conduction. Clear? So that's why here we have this 120 degree in one cycle. 60 degree here and 60 degree here. Total 120 degree in one cycle of output voltage. Now for lane number 3, S2 and S3. Same. Yes?
We are asking you to S6 1 with the 360 that we are needing, 60-61, but it didn't mean you only. That's how okay with the higher
voltage. See, each one cycle, each and every switch conducting for 120 degree duration. You can see the S1 is conducting from 0. So at 120. Okay. Same way here, S4 starts from 180, so at is 300. So duration is 120. Next, in the cycle, 360 degree again it starts. So it's conducting up to 120. Okay. Same way here, you can see that S1 and S3, they have phase displacement of 120 degree. So same line of 180 mode, S3 starts from 120 degree. And add it to 240 because conduction duration is 120. Then 60 degree neither S3 nor S6 will be conducting. So at 300 degree, your S6 will start. But at 360 degree, this cycle is completed. So next 60 degree that will conduct in the next cycle. So that 60 degree you get with the initial period. This 60 degree conduction of S6, it means that in the previous cycle already your S6 in conduction mode. So in this cycle, between 0 to 360, you can see that this 60 degree has 6 conduction and this 60 degree conduction. The total is 120 degree. So each and every thyristor is conducting for 120 degree in one cycle of an output. Now, lane number 3, IG5 and IG2. So again, S5 is conducting 120 degree after conduction of S3. So you can see that S3 is conducting at 120. So 120 degree after S3 convection is at 240 degree. Same like 180 degree. If you see the waveform of 180 degree, same waveform is true. So here starting point or conduction starting point of all thyristors is same as the 180 degree mode, but the cutoff time is different. Yeah, because here it is the 120 degree. So from 240 to next 120 degree, it means 360 degree. Here, your S5 will conduct here. This way. S5 is here. So before 240 degree, as we know, there is 60 degree interval, neither S5 nor S2 will conduct here. So gate pulse is 0. But before 180 degree, duration of 120 degree means 60 to 180. This is 0, 60 and 120. So 60 to 180, your S2 will be conducting. Again 0 to 60, no one will conduct S5 or S2. Clear? Again, after the conduction of S5, when it is off at 360 degree, from 360 to 60 degree again, there is no gate pulse. But after 60 degree, again your S2 will start conducting. This is your S2 conduction. So here I just put the gate pulse for only one cycle of your output voltage. Same way you can do for the next cycle also. All of you clear this one? Gate pulse. Is there a doubt to anyone? Yes or no? Is there a doubt? In the gate pulse, how we apply the gate pulse in 120 degree mode? All of you? Is there a doubt?
No sir, no.
Okay. So let's start doing the waveform of phase voltage. VA0, VB0 and VC0. Same like we have done for the 180 degree. So first of all, we just draw this gate first. Then after, we have to draw the waveform phase voltage. VA0, VB0 and VC0. By drawing the equivalent circuits. So now you can see that here, write down the conduction duration for all the 6 steps. Same like a 180 degree mode here, in one cycle, we have 6 steps, each of 60 degree interval. So you can see that 0 to 60 degree interval, which thyristors are in conduction mode? From this gate pulse, you can identify the gate, identify the switches which are in turn on mode. So between 0 to 60, which thyristor is on? Yes, anyone? Give me the answer. Between 0 to 60 degree. S1 is conducting 0 to 120. So it means 0 to 60 it is on. Here you can see that S6, that is also conducting between 0 to 60 degree. But here 0 to 60 in the third leg, neither S5 nor S2 is not conducting. So it means only two switches is conducting between 0 to 60 degree. Switch number S1 and S6. So here I write 6 and 1. 6 and 1. That is the switch which is conducting from 0 to 60. Clear? Any doubt? Now next 60 to 120. Which switches are in conduction mode? Or which switches are in on mode? So here you can see that 60 degree S6 is off. Switch number 6 is off. 1 is on. Between 60 to 120. Here, third leg S2 is on between 60 to 120. It means one end is conducting. One end is conducting. Same way in the third leg, S1 is off. So, first leg, no one thyristor is in conduction. Second leg, S3 is conducting. And third leg, S2 is conducting. So, 2 and 3 thyristor are in conduction. Then in the fourth step, between 180 to 240, S4 is conducting and S3 is conducting. S2, S1 is off. So 3 and 4. Then fifth interval, S4 and S1. And last, sixth interval, S1, S2 off, S6 is on, S1 is on. So 5 and 6 is on. Next cycle again, this sequence is repeated. You can see that S1 is on, S6 is on, S5 and S2 is on. So it is 6 and 1. Same line between first 0 to 63. Same way again, same line 1 and 3 is coming. You can see here. Here 1 and 3 is coming. Allow me to clear this conduction equation of all the switches between 0 to 60. Is there any doubt? So, same like a 180 degree mode. For each and every interval, draw the equivalent circuit of this three phase inverter and calculate the phase voltage VA0, VB0, and VC0. Okay? So, first 0 to 60 degree interval, you can see that switch number 6 and 1 is converted. Switch number 6 and 1. So, we represent this on switch as a closed switch. So switch number 1 and 6 is closed and the remaining switch is off, so that we represent by the open circuit. We represent by open circuit. Switch number S1, this is S6, S3, S5, S4. So you can see that here in the 120 degree mode only 2 switches on at a time, where in the 180 degree mode 3 switches are on. Here. So that is the difference between 180 and 120 degree. Now if you observe that in this sequence of conduction of thyristor, at a time one switch is conducting from upper group of thyristor. We call S1, S3 and S5 as upper group thyristor and S4, S6 and S2 as a lower group thyristor. So at a time one thyristor is conducting from upper group and one thyristor is conducting from the lower group. First interval from the upper group thyristor number 1 is conducting and from the lower group S6 is conducting. Clear? So first of all draw the equivalent circuit for the first mode so that you can draw the phase voltages for all the three phases. Clear? I hope all of you have drawn this waveform. Now you please draw this phase voltage in the same below the same page below this waveform. Okay, so you can easily take the projection and understand. Now we first draw the waveform of phase A for the interval number 1. That is VA0. Here. Now, first of all, I will do the equivalent circuit. So, this is your supply voltage. S1 switch is conducting and it is connected with the phase A impedance Z. So, this is impedance Z. This is A point. And then, as you see the phase C, all the switches S2 and S2 that is in off condition. Here. So, current will never flow into this phase number C. So whatever current is flowing into the phase A, same current is leaving from the phase B and reaching to this negative terminal of supply. So this Z and this Z are connected in series. Phase A is here and phase B is here, connected in series. The middle point is neutral, this is point B and this is your supply voltage V. And this is your total current I, which is flowing from the supply. Okay. So now, what is the equation of output voltage VA0 and VB0? Yes, anyone?
VA0 VS by 2 and VB0 minus VS0.
Yes, anyone? What is the VA0 and VB0? Mantar, who number?
VA0 equal to positive VS and VB0 equal to minus VS.
How it is VS? Your supply voltage, total supply voltage is VS. So what is this voltage? VA0, this voltage. And what is VB0 on this?
VS by 2, sorry.
Yes, it is VS by 2. VA0 is VS by 2, but what is VB0? Yes, Mandar, what is VB0?
Minus VS by 2.
Yes, very good. It is minus VS by 2. Here. Because you measure the voltage with respect to V. Clear? So here you can see that both the impedance connected in series. supply voltage is Vs. So across each phase, you get the half of the supply voltage, means Vs by 2 and Vs by 2. But if you measure the voltage of phase B with respect to neutral, then this minus Vs by 2. If you measure with respect to B, then it is plus Vs by 2. Okay. So it means that here Vs0 is equal to VB0 is equal to what? Vs by 2. Sorry. VOB, that is Vs by 2. But VB0 is what? Minus Vs by 2. And VCO is what? 0. Because 0 current is flowing through phase C impedance. There is no voltage drop here. So let's draw the waveform of Vs0, VB0 and VC0 for first interval between 0 to 60 degrees. Now please draw the waveform and write the calculation also. So first interval Vs0 is plus Vs by 2. It is plus Vs by 2. Take the projection that it is only for 0 to 60 degree. Okay. This is Vs by 2. VB0 is minus Vs by 2. VB0 is minus Vs by 2. And VC0 is 0. This is 0. Now same way for interval number 2, when 1 and 2 is on between 60 to 120. Switch number 1 and 2 is connected. 1 and 2. This is after the close switch. Now S6 become off. Clear. So now draw the equivalent circuit for this case. S1 is connected to the phase A, this impedance, and phase C, this impedance connected in series. Now phase B, voltage to get 0, because no one current is flowing from this phase number C. Okay. So same like this circuit diagram, but just change what? Here this is phase C. Here, this is phase C. Phase A is here, this is impedance of phase A, this is neutral, and this is the impedance of phase C, and current is written to this negative terminal through switch number S2. So again, you get VA0 is what? Plus Vs by 2? Yes or no? All of you? Three number approach?
Yes, sir.
Again, you get VA0, Vs by 2. Yes or no?
Yes,
now,
sir.
Now, what is the VC0?
Minus Vs by 2.
Yes, and VB0 is what?
0.
Yes, right. So, again, you go to the waveform. So, between 60 to 120 degree, your VA0 is Vs by 2. It's the same as you get for Vs by 0 to 60 degree. All of you, please draw the waveform with the projection. So you can able to draw this waveform brilliantly. Okay, so 60 to 120 again Vs by 2. Now VB0 is what? 0. And VC0 is minus Vs by 2. So it is minus Vs by 2. Now same way for third interval between 120 to 180. Now give me the answer of all the phase voltages. VA0, VB0, VC0. All of them. Number 4, give me the answer of VA0, VB0, VC0 for interval number 3. Okay, 4 number is absent. 5 number zero. Give the answer for this interval. When 2 by 3 is conducting. Draw the equivalent circuit like this way and find out VA0, VB0, VC0. 2 and 3 is connected. 1 is off now, 3 acts as a closed switch. So only phase B and C come into picture, because from phase A, neither S1 nor S4 is connected. Here. So obviously phase A voltage becomes 0, it means VA0 is 0. Now you get the voltage only VB0 and VC0. What is the value of this? Yes, 5 over, same. What is VA0? And what is VB0, VC0?
VB0, VS by 2.
VB0 is VS by 2, yes, very good.
VC0 minus VS by 2.
Yes, very good. So VA0 is 0 because no one switch is conducting. So from 120 to 180, VA0 is 0. VB0 is plus VS by 2. And VC0 is minus VS by 2. Clear? Now again, for fourth step, 180 to 240, 3 and 4 is conducting. So what is the voltage? Number 6, Yura C. Give me the answer.
Yes, sir.
VA0, VA0, VA0.
VA0 minus VS by 2.
Yes, very good. It is minus VS by 2. Then
VB0 plus VS by 2.
Very good. It is plus VS by 2 and VC0?
0.
Yes, VC0 is 0. This is 240. Same way. For next step, 242, 300. Number 7, sorry, number 9, 9.
Yes, sir.
For fifth step, where 4 and 5 is connecting. What is VA0, VB0, VC0? VA0
minus VS by
2.
VA will be minus.
Yes?
Minus VS by 2.
Yes, it is minus VS by 2, VA0. Then VB0?
0.
VC0?
VC0 plus VS by 2.
Yes, very good. It is plus VS by 2. Then last step number 6, from 300 to 360. 5 and 6 is conducting. 5 and 6 is conducting. The remaining are in half condition. Now, what is VA0, VC0, VC0? Next number, 11 number, Ravi. What is VA0?
Just a minute. I don't know that the screen is not getting on my screen.
Sorry?
I'm not able to see your screen, sir.
Which screen? The bottom of the screen?
Yes, sir.
My phone finger to drop kar gaya na.
Aisa nahi sir, ye screen hi nahi dikh raha, matlab aapki awaaz aa rahi hai par screen nahi aa raha.
तो आपका वीडियो ऑफ करके ऑन करो वापस, तो वापस ऑन था।
एक सेकंड सर, ज्वाइन होता हूँ वापस।
ओके, नेक्स्ट नंबर 13 नंबर 2, व्हाट इज VA0?
यस सर, 0 सर।
यस, इट इज 0, VA0 इज 0, फ्रॉम 300 टू 360
डिग्री। देन VB0? माइनस VS बाय 2।
यस, माइनस VS बाय 2, एंड VC0 इज?
Plus VS by 2.
Yeah. So you can see that 360 degrees completely. Same value is repeated for the next cycle after 360 degrees. Okay, so there is no need to draw the waveform for next cycle. Just draw for only one cycle. So here I am highlighting all the phase voltages for all the different intervals. Now, from this phase voltage, draw the line voltage. VAB, VBC and VCD. Okay. So as you know the value of VA0 and VB0, so you can able to find out the value of VAB. VAB is what? VA0. VAB is what? वी ए जीरो माइनस वी बी जीरो. Here you know the value of each phase for different interval, so you can find out the all these line voltages. So find out these line voltages and represent it in terms of waveform also. So first interval between 0 to 60 degree, VAB, that is what? VA0 minus VB0. VA0 is what? Between 0 to 60, it is VS by 2. So it is VS by 2 minus, what is VB0? VB0 is minus VS by 2. So minus minus plus, so VS by 2 plus VS by 2. So you get plus VS. So VAB in the first interval between 0 to 60 degree, that is VS. Clear? So let's draw the waveform for VAB. Then for the remaining waveform, VBC and VCA, you draw it by yourself. So VAB in first 60 degree interval, that voltage is VS. Yes, so here I draw this waveform, it is VS. VAB. Then 60 to 120, what is VAB? VA0 is VS by 2, VB0 is 0. So what is the value of VAB? That is 0? Yes or no? Between 0 to 60, you get VS. Then 60 to 120, you get only VS by 2. Clear? Then after 120 to 180, VA0 is 0 and VB0 is what? Plus VS by 2. So your VAB is what? Minus VS by 2. You are again write the equation of VAB. VA0 minus VB0. Just put the value of all the phase voltage VA0 and VB0. So you can get it. So 120 to 180, it is minus VS by 2. Then fourth interval 180 to 240. VA0 is what? Minus VS by 2 and VB0 is plus VS by 2. Clear? So it is minus VS by 2 minus VS by 2. So it is minus VS. So it means 180 to 240, your VAB is what? Minus VS. Minus VS. Then 240 to 300. 240 to 300. VA0 is minus VS by 2, VB0 is 0, it is minus VS by 2. Then 300 to 360 degree, VA0 is 0, VB0 is minus VS by 2, so minus minus plus, so it is plus VS by 2, from 300 to 360 degree. So I highlight this portion to VAB. Same way you can draw the waveform of other line voltages, VB0 and VC0. This one is clear to all of you. Is there any doubt? In this line voltage VAB, same way you can find out VB, VBC, VBO minus VC. Same way VCA, that is VCO minus VB. So just simple put the value for each and every interval and then row in terms of waveform. Clear? All of this here? Is there any doubt? Where you? All of it? Clear this one? So next point is write down. Will I do that here? Okay. And now next thing, Fourier analysis of phase voltage waveform. Fourier analysis of phase voltage waveform. Phase voltage is VAB, VS0, VB0 and VC0. So here directly you write the equation of this phase voltage is Fourier equation. Summation of L135 up to infinite 2 Vs by N pi cos N pi by 6 into sin N omega t plus pi by 6. This is the equation of Fourier analysis of phase A voltage. Phase A voltage, Fourier analysis equation. VB0, VB is phase B, Fourier analysis equation, N is equal to 135 up to infinite 2 Vs by N pi cos N pi by 6 sin N omega t minus pi by 2. Minus pi by 2. And VC is 0, N is equal to 135 up to infinite 2 Vs by N pi cos N pi by 6 sin N omega t plus 5 pi by 6. It's 150 plus 1. So this is the Fourier analysis equation of phase voltage. Fourier analysis equation of phase voltage. Then Fourier analysis of this line voltage. Fourier analysis. Now you can see that this switch number 1 and switch number 4. As you see that in the 180 degree mode, S1 is turned on from 0 to 180, and then after 180 360, S4 is on. But if you see the practically, it is possible that S1 is off at 180 and at the same time S4 is on. It is possible practically. If it happens when S1 is on at 180 and S4 is also on at 180, so what will happen? The supply is short circuited. Yes sir. So practically 180 degree mode is not possible because thyristor has some turn off time. Thyristor requires some turn off time, or you can say that each and every device requires some commutation time. Commutation means turning off of the switch, as you already know that. So commutation is not sufficiently provided to this thyristor in 180 degree mode. So each and every thyristor has not sufficient commutation time in 180 degree mode. So it is practically not possible. So you can operate 180 degree mode less than 180 degree convection for each and every switch. But if you see the 120 degree mode, if you see the gate pulse, S1 is turned on at 0 to 120, but S4 is turned on at 180. That's again going to be free form here. You can understand. So this is 0 to 120, where your S1 is conducting, but S4 is conducting at 180 up to 300 degree. This is 180 at 300 degree. Conduction of S4. And this is conduction of S1. So there is a 60 degree gap between the conduction of S1 and S4. So you can see that when S1 is off at 120 degree duration, after that it gets the sufficient duration of 60 degree to completely turn off. It means that in each and every device in 120 degree mode get the sufficient computation time. So there is no any computation overlap, or there are no chances of short circuit of the supply. If you see that waveform of all the gate pulse or lane number 1, 2, and 3, each and every lane complementary switches are turned on after 60 degree interval. So there is a sufficient duration get by each and every device to completely regain its forward blocking capacity. So there is no possibility of short circuit of the supply. So this is the one of the advantages of 120 degree mode of inverter. Then after we see that by example that power output given by 180 degree mode, that is more than power output given by this 120 degree. That we see in the next lecture in the example. Okay, then after write down all of you. Next point. RMS value of fundamental phase voltage. RMS value of fundamental phase voltage. RMS value of fundamental phase voltage. So here you can see that phase voltage is given VA0, VB0, VC. So what is the peak value here? It is VS by N5 into cos N5 by 6. That is the peak value. It is look like this VM, this sine omega t. Yes, sine omega t is this way. So VM is 2VS by N5 cos N5 by 6. Here we require RMS value of fundamental component. Fundamental means N equal to 1. So we have peak value of fundamental component Vm1, that is 2Vs by 5 because n is equal to 1, and is cos 5 by 6. So that is peak value. So what is the RMS value of fundamental component? Vrms1, peak divided by root 2. So it is 2Vs by 5 cos 5 by 6 divided by root 2. So this is the value of RMS fundamental phase voltage. RMS value of फंडामेंटल फेज वोल्टेज. सो cos pi by 6 इज व्हाट cos 30 root 3 by 2. सो पुट दिस वैल्यू हियर 2 Vs by 5 root 3 by 2 divided by root 3. So what is the value in terms of Vs? Calculate this. Sorry? No, sin 30 1 by 2. Sin 30 is 1 by 2. Yes or no? Cos 30 is what? Root 3 by 2. Yes or no? So what is the value in terms of Vs? If you calculate this, so you get the value 0.3898 Vs. 0.3898 times Vs. All of you get this answer? Next thing, write down RMS value of phase voltage. RMS value of phase voltage. RMS value of phase voltage. So as you already know the waveform of phase voltage, VA0, VB0 and VC0. So let's calculate the RMS value of phase A. So first of all, see the waveform of phase A. What is the magnitude in 1 second? What is the magnitude of VA0 in 1 second? Between 0 to 120 you get plus VA. Yes or no? VA0. Then 122, 180, it is 0. Then 182, 300 degree, it is minus Vs. And 302, 360, it is 0. So now what is the RMS value of this phase voltage? So as you know the equation of RMS value of phase voltage, RMS of phase voltage, 1 upon 2 pi, because we calculate RMS for 1 full cycle. Then integration 0 to 2 pi, its output voltage V0 whole square d omega t raised to 1 by 2. So in 1 cycle you can see that in half cycle you get the output between 0 to 121 and magnitude is what? Vs. Same way in the next half cycle we get the magnitude only between the 120 integration and magnitude is minus Vs. Okay. But here you can see that output voltage square, it means this negative also becomes positive in the RMS value calculation. Okay. So if you calculate RMS value of a half cycle only and multiply with the 2, so you get the RMS value of 1 full cycle. Okay. So here I multiply it 2 times 1 upon 2 pi. Take the integration only 0 to pi, but in the 0 to pi, you can see that you get the output only between 0 to 120 degree. It means 0 to 2 pi by 3. So I take the integration only 0 to 2 pi by 3, output voltage is how much? Vs. So it is Vs whole square d omega t raised to 1 by 2. To cancel out. Now, simplify this equation and find out the value. Vs square, that is constant. So Vs square divided by pi. D omega t, integration is omega t from 0 to 2 pi by 3 raised to 1 by 2. Here. So here, Vs square divided by pi, 2 pi by 3 minus 0 raised to 1 by 2. So pi pi cancel out. So it is Vs by root 3. Sorry?
Yeah,
so is 2 by 3 VS. Sorry. Square root of 2 by 3 into VS. Square root of 2 by 3 into VS.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, phase voltage to VS by 2, right?
Sorry. So it is Vs square divided by 4. Yes, this is my mistake. It is Vs square divided by 4. So here you get Vs by 2. Square root of 2 by 3 into Vs by 2. So it is Vs by 2 6. Yes, it is Vs by 2. Sorry. Each phase voltage maximum value is Vs by 2. Now next thing, write down RMS value of fundamental line voltage. RMS value of fundamental line voltage. Fundamental line voltage. So as you see that in the previous way, we calculate the RMS value of fundamental phase voltage. That is what RMS value of fundamental voltage, VRMS value. We have calculated that is 0.3898 times VS. Yes. This is the RMS value of fundamental RMS value of phase voltage. Now we require RMS value of fundamental line voltage. So what is the relation between phase and line? Line voltage is what? Root 3 times phase voltage. Here, it means root 3 times 0.3898 times Vs. So, line voltage RMS value of fundamental component is equal to root 3 times 0.3898 times Vs. It means you get the answer 0.6752 Vs. 0.6752 times Vs. Next, write down RMS value of line voltage. Just RMS value of line voltage. This is the RMS value of fundamental line voltage. It means for n is equal to 1. Now write down RMS value of line voltage. Again, we have calculated the RMS value of phase voltage, that is Vs by root 6. That is the RMS value of phase voltage. So what is the RMS value of line voltage? Vs by root 3 times Vs by root 6. Clear? RMS value of line voltage. Is equal to root 3 times RMS value of phase voltage. Then we already calculated Vs by root 6. So it is root 3 divided by Vs by root 6. So it is Vs by root 2. So it is 0.7071 times Vs. So here I complete this lecture. The next lecture we calculate the example related to this 180 and 120 degree mode of inverter. I hope all of you understand this 120 degree mode. And more differences we can discuss later on in the next lecture. What are the other differences? And thereafter we conclude that which one is better. Okay. So today in the practical session, we will simulate the first 180 degree mode and then after 120 degree. So, by simulation also, will verify that which mode of inverter is better, 180 or 120. By FFT analysis and by magnitude of output voltage, we can check that which mode is better through the simulation also. So today in the lab session, we start next practical simulation of 180 and 120 degree mode of inverter. So all of you please come to practical session by reading all these two modes, 120 and 180 degree modes. So all of you will understand better. Is there any doubt to anyone? Yes, anyone?